Last weeks, we've talked about our new robots in the small payload area. We talked about the new KRC5 micro controller, which is the first in a new generation of controllers, which will come to all of our robots. It will take some time before they are fully implemented over the complete workspace product range, roughly 2 years from now, and they will all have been equipped with the KRC5 controllers. And along with the KRC5 controller comes a new version of our system software, which has then a designation of 8.7. And as I said last week, why do we do this? Well, from a hardware point of view, we need to secure the availability of components so we can keep supporting you with new products and spare parts for the existing products. We need to minimize our complexity in our deliveries, and that would mean fewer spare parts for you to handle. Increasingly important is also to be energy efficient. So with a new hardware platform, we can actually reduce energy consumption for the same movement that we would do with compared to what we will use with the KRC4 controller. And of course, we also need a software platform which we can develop and grow on, to be future-proof and inventive, innovative for the future. So that means that actually today we have two versions of the KUKA system software which are delivered. It is the KSS 8.6, which is delivered with all our KRC4 controllers, and the KSS 8.7, which are delivered with the KRC5 generation of controllers. And just to be quite clear, the 8.7 is what we call a functional twin of 8.6. That means that from a software point of view, there's actually no handling difference between 8.6 and 8.7. And by this, what we really mean is that from a documentation point of view, there is actually one set of customer documentation to you. In both cases, 8.6 and 8.7, we use Work Visual 6.0. So there's only one engineering environment. If we use the smart HMI option together with our robots, it's an identical site interaction for the operator. And talking about programming, the KRL code is identical between these two versions. The technology packages available to the options, to the controller, sorry, are identical. So the difference is the hardware platform, which are different. Any questions so far on that? That also means that the 8.6 is still a valid product that is still developed with new features, since for at least the 2 years, this will still be a delivered system platform until all controllers are replaced with the KRC5. There are new functionalities which came with the 8.6, and there are new functionalities coming continuously to the 8.6. So the 8.6 will be up to date at all times. What these functionalities are, we will get back to a little bit later. And of course, the 8.7, which is can only be used with the KRC5 platforms, are have some new features, which are for the new mainly which are for the new robots we talked about, the KR4 and the SCARA robots so far. That means that for these two robots, they are only available with the KRC5 and the 8.7 KSS platform. So if we dive into the news of 8.6, and news is a thing with which you could discuss, because 8.6 has already been around for a year or more, and these functions have been there for a year, and that's why I asked if you are aware of these new functionalities, because they will save you quite a lot of time when it comes to engineering. It will give you quite a few advantages to your customer as well. And these, all these are just a few of them. There are quite a few more. And I will not go into detail into them, all of them, during this webinar, because that will take several hours then. We just have our half an hour to go into them. I will shortly dive into a few of them, just as a teaser. One new feature is that more and more of the setup part of the robots are moving from hardware physics into software adaptions. For example, supply voltage, installation angle, movement modes, which earlier were hardware dependent, now goes into software settings. That means that regardless of application, we can have the same hardware and just change the application with a software setting, which makes it easier for us and for you during commissioning, setup, and so on. And this is a continuous process. The more and more of the hardware options are moving into settable through software. One very important feature is the braking before restricted areas. That means that when we use safe operation or safe range monitoring options, instead of just stopping reactions where we don't really know where the robot stops if we hit the emergency brakes, the robot actually predetermines its coming positions in the short period of the near future, depending on the movement it's doing, and make sure that if it comes close to a restricted area, it automatically slows down the movement. So it always has the time to stop safely before entering a restricted area. And that means and these are safe functions according to PLD. And that gives us a predictable robot movement, which has a foresight in its movement. That means that it actually do a little look into the future movement, coming movement, and make sure that it always stops before a restricted area, regardless of speed it has when it starts the air movement, actually. There is also, for example, a new jog mode available in the KSS 8.6 and 8.5, 8.7. It's early, sorry. And there are also new kinematics for our robots. Since we have new robots in the 8.7, there are also new kinematics available. For example, for the Scara robot, there is a hop motion, which you can imagine is hop from A to B, typically if you know how a Scara robot works. And as I said, all these new functions aim at making your project more efficient and save time during it. And let me go backwards a bit to the overview, because this are quite a few new functionalities. There, we talked about the software-based adaptions, but there are collision detection options. There's a new scripting platform. The conveyor-based application has been heavily advanced with the new features. There is a new field bus connectivity mastering function. That means that you can define your, for example, Profinet directly in the work visual. There are new field bus functionalities, for example, with Profinet, fast replace of devicements, new functionalities for field bus diagnostics. For the KRC5, you've seen there last week that there were a hell of a lot of Ethernet ports with dedicated functionality. And that means in reality that these 8 ports have dedicated functionalities. And at the end of the day, you will probably not use all of them. Then you can actually, software-wise, change the functionality of this of these ports. So you instead get a standard Ethernet switch on board. And that would save you additional hardware in the cabinet, for example. There's a possibility to have centralized user administration, even from an Active Directory, which is a huge benefit if you have several robots in your installation where you can handle these users centrally. There are new versions of inline forms when you write your logic, which assists you to have the right syntax when you write your KRL code. I mentioned the new kinematics just now. When it comes to safety, the systems can monitoring the safety checksum and alert us if there are any changes made to the safety system. We had a quick look at the braking before restricted areas and the new jog modes, and there are so much more. So take the time and book a workshop with us, because going through this and with you and your technicians takes a few hours, actually. And we will do that with a workshop with you, either online or on site with you, depending on when and where we are. And of course, the virus situation, we all know. And that is, of course, free of charge. So I can only urge you to get in contact with me or your local sales representative, and we will book this with you. And we will make sure it's worth your time. It's well spent hours to do this. So I see we have a few questions, and I got a few answers on my initial question. Tobias has good knowledge of the new functionalities. He got it from Thomas, but a few of you haven't. And Ricky made a comment that the braking before restricted area also means that if a robot is run close to a restricted area, cycle times will be lower. Yeah, that's correct. Can this be checked in a simulation? I'm actually not sure, Ricky. I'll have to get back to you. I'll get back to you on that. I'm not sure, actually. Otherwise, of course, as you know, there are a lot of software options available to the 8.6, and all these are also available to the 8.7, with a few new ones actually available, both to 8.7 and 8.6. For example, there is a serial interface, for those of you who need this. There is a USB port security option, which actually blocks the USB ports from unapproved use of the USB ports on the controller. And there is a new version of the device connector, which gives the controller an OPC UA functionality, so you can distribute your information in your factory network from the robots, for example. All these are available for both 8.6 and 8.7. Now, that pretty much sums up what I had to say about 8.7. So, as you noticed, this was more of a teaser of all the new functions available in 8.7. I, again, hope that we get the chance and you take the chance to book a workshop with us where we go into depth of these functionalities a little bit more, because that will make your work more efficient and you will be able to provide some pretty neat customer features as well, benefits, which makes you look stronger with your customers as well. Orange Intelligence.